How are you guys? I just want to give you lessons in line with inference, rules of inference. So we advise you to spread the news that we also give you lessons, be it in programming and other categories. And also today we just want to look at Zoho classes that are having problem with rules of inference. So first I want to look at modus tollens and modus ponens. Okay. Maybe my question or the problem is, if I go to town, then I will attend the lesson. So as you can see from this statement, we can break it into two parts. Go to town, I can denote it with A. Then we'll attend the lesson, I will denote it with B. So if I go to town, then I will attend the lesson, I will represent it like A implies B. So you should know truth table of A implies B. The truth table of A implies B will be, let's say we have our parameter A and B, then we have this result A implies B. Okay, so we have T false T F. So for implies, you only get a false if you have false here and true here. So here is false and the rest it will be true. So that's how we, so if that's the output of implies truth table. So if I go to town, then I'll attend the lesson, we have this truth table. Okay. So if I go to town, then I'll attend the lesson, will be A implies B. Then if it's B, therefore A, you just want to see if this statement is valid. So maybe the topic is, we just want to test the validity of this statement. So from here, if I go to town, then I'll attend the lesson. I attend the lessons, therefore I went to town. That's what I want to test here. Okay. Let me write the statement. If I go to town, then I will attend the lesson. That's statement A. That's my first statement. Then B, I attended the lesson. So B is attend the lesson. I attended the lesson. Therefore, I went to town. I went to town. So that's what I want to test its validity. So for you to test the validity, you are supposed to test this statement A implies B, which is our first statement. If I go to town, then I'll attend the lesson. Conjunction with B. So in other words, you should know these are the premises. These are the premises and this is the conclusion. So we have two premises here. This is the first premises. This is the first premises, and this is the conclusion. So for you to test its validity, you should say this expression, conjunction with B, then in brackets, implies the conclusion, which is A. So if this statement is a tautology, then it means this statement is valid. So we have to test if this statement is a tautology. So that's where I want to measure to test its validity. Okay, so how many variables do we have here? I have two variables. So first of all, A, B. A, B, then A implies B, which is this part. B, we have it already. A, we have it already. Okay, so true, true, false, false. True, false, true, false. Then here, false, true, true, true. Okay, this one conjunction with B, so we are multiplying since this is a conjunction. So this and this, T times T, or T and T is T, F and F is F, T and T is T, F and T is F. So for this one, it's for this statement, A implies B, or we can write A implies B, conjunction with B, we have this result. Now, we want to say this implies A, so this part implies A, true, true is true, false, true is true, true, false is false, false, false is true. As you can see, this statement is not a tautology. This statement is not a tautology. This statement is not a tautology. So maybe if I say A implies B, A therefore B, I just want to test this statement. If I go to town, then I will attend the lesson. Then here, therefore, I just want to swap. This part should be the last part. Okay, I just want to swap the statement. So A, I went to town. I went to town. Therefore, I attended the lesson. Therefore, I attended the lesson. So as you can see, the previous lesson, the previous statement, didn't give us a tautology, since the result was not giving us OTTT. But we now want to test this part. So our premises here, we have A implies B and A. So here we change it to A, and here is our B is the result. Okay, now I'm going to change something here. Here it remains A implies B, since this is A implies B. Then here, instead of A, instead of B, is now A. Okay, now I want to apply this and this. T and T is T, T and F is F, F and T, F and T, it's F. Then F and T is F. Now I want A implies B, conjunction with A, then implies B. Since I have this result, which is this part, I want to say implies A. So true and true is true, false and true is true, false and false is true, false and false is true. So as you can see, this part gives us what we call a tautology. Therefore, we can conclude that this statement is valid. So the statement, if I go to town, then I will attend the lesson. I went to town, therefore I attended the lesson. This statement, it's valid. So thank you guys for following this lesson. I'll keep on giving you so many videos that can help you. So this class is for Zoe students, those who are doing mathematical foundation. I know you have an assignment that is due, that a weaving basket statement or question that you're having problem with. But unfortunately, subscribe to our channel so that I will answer that question, a weaving basket question. Maybe our next video, I'll answer that question. Thank you guys for subscribing to our YouTube channel, Pastor Zay TV. Thank you. See you next time. Wanagirosa tipe commenti, my drama, my videos, name a comedy. Appetizing entertainment, kakusara, chungu ita chimbi chimbi, Pastor Zay TV.